स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणे अवतारवरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः यथाग्नेर्दाहिका शक्ति रामकृष्णे स्थिता हिया सर्वविद्यास्वरूपां तां शारदां प्रणमाम्यहं नमः श्रीयतिराजाय विवेकानन्दसूरये सच्चित्सुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः कायेन वाचा मनसेन्द्रियैर्वा बुद्ध्यात्मना वा प्रकृते स्वभावात् करोमि यद्यत् सकलं परस्मै नारायणायेति समर्पयामि ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ నిస్వార్థ ప్రార్థన ఇతరుల శ్రేయస్సు కోసరం మంచి కోసరం ప్రార్థన చేద్దాం. సర్వే భవంతు సుఖినః సర్వే సంతు నిరామయాః సర్వే భద్రాణి పశ్యంతు మా కశ్చిద్ దుఃఖభాగ్ భవేత్. సర్వస్తరతు దుర్గాణి సర్వో భద్రాణి పశ్యతు सर्वसद्बुद्धिमाप्नोतु सर्वसर्वत्र नन्दतु हरिः ॐ. स्थिरंगा कूर्चनि श्वास निश्वासं समानं चेसुकुंटू हृदय कमलं पैन भगवान् श्रीरामकृष्णुलु कूर्चुन्नारनि భావించండి. ప్రశాంత వాతావరణం మీ ఇళ్లల్లో మఠంలో. ఈ ప్రశాంత వాతావరణంలో మనం ధ్యానం చేయడం సంధ్యా సమయం చాలా మంచిది. అలవాటు చేసుకోవాలి, ఒక రొటీన్ చేసుకోవాలి. రామకృష్ణ స్థవరాజం నుంచి చదువుతాను శ్లోకము మరియు తాత్పర్యం. వింటూ భావించండి, ఏకాగ్రత పెంచుకోండి. ధ్యానం చేసేటప్పుడు ఉత్సాహం ఉండాలి, శ్రద్ధ ఉండాలి, ప్రేమ కలగాలి, భక్తి కలగాలి. ఓంకార వేద్య పురుష పురాణో బుద్ధేశ్చ సాక్షీ నిఖిలస్య జంతో యో వేత్తి సర్వం నచయస్య వేత్త పరాత్మరూపో భువి రామకృష్ణ. ప్రణవనాదమైన ఓంకారముచే తెలియబడు వాడవు సర్వజీవులలో బుద్ధి అనబడు ఆత్మచేతన రూపములో సాక్షిగా నిలచినవాడవు. ఓ రామకృష్ణ, నువ్వు సమస్తము తెలిసినవాడవు, సర్వజ్ఞుడవు, కానీ నిన్ను తెలుసుకోగలిగేవారు ఎవరూ లేరు. పరమాత్ముడవైన నువ్వు ఇచ్ఛామాత్రంగా ఈ భువిపై అవతరించావు. థౌ ఆర్ ద ప్రిమేవియల్ బీయింగ్ sought to be known through the Omkara, in all creatures. Thou art the witness of their self-conscious intelligence. Thou knowest all, Sarvagnaha, but there is none that knows thee. O Ramakrishna, thou art verily the Supreme Self, manifest as the Lord incarnate on the earth. Mokshasvarupam tava dhama nityam yatha tadapnoti vishuddha chittaha tatopadeshtha akhila tattva vetta tvam vishvadhata bhuvi rama krishnaha. O Ramakrishna, neevu ellappudu nityananda dayakamaina ముక్త స్థితిలో ఉంటావు. నీవు సమస్త తత్వజ్ఞాన సంపన్నుడవు. పరిశుద్ధమైన మానసం కలవారు ఆ మోక్షధామాన్ని ఎలా పొందగలరో నీ ఉపదేశములలో చూపావు. ఆ విధంగా భూమిపై అవతరించిన ఓ రామకృష్ణ, నీవు విశ్వములోని అసంఖ్యాక జనులకు ఆధారభూతుడవు. ఓ రామకృష్ణ, థై ఎటర్నల్ స్టేటస్ ఇస్ మోక్ష. ద వే హౌ ద ప్యూర్ మైండెడ్ కుడ్ అటైన్ ఇట్ వాజ్ షోన్ బై దీ, ద నోవర్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ట్రూత్, త్రూ థై ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్. తేజోమయం దర్శయసి స్వరూపం కోశాంతరస్థం పరమార్థతత్వం సంస్పర్శమాత్రేణ నృణాం సమాధిం విధాయ సద్యో భువి రామకృష్ణః. స్పర్శమాత్రం చేత ఆధ్యాత్మిక సాధకులకు భావసమాధిని అనుగ్రహించగల సమర్థుడవు. పంచకోశాంతర్గతమైన స్వయం ప్రకాశక శుద్ధ చైతన్యంగా భాసిల్లు నీ నిజస్వరూపం సాధకులకు పరమార్థతత్వాన్ని వెల్లడి చేస్తుంది. అట్టి పరమాత్ముడవైన నీవు భువిపై శ్రీరామకృష్ణునిగా అవతరించావు. హూ ఇండ్యూసింగ్ సమాధి ఇన్ ఆస్పైరెంట్స్ బై హిస్ మియర్ టచ్ రివీల్ టు దెమ్ ద సుప్రీం ట్రుత్ దై రియల్ నేచర్ యాజ్ లుమినస్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ ఇన్ ద ఇన్నర్ మోస్ట్ కోర్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫైవ్ కోశాస్. That Supreme Spirit art thou, O Ramakrishna, manifest on this earth. Ragadi shunyam tava saumya murtim drishtva punaschatra na janma bhajaha. స్థానే యదాదాయ విశుద్ధసత్వం ఇహావతీర్ణో భువి రామకృష్ణః. ఓ రామకృష్ణ, శుద్ధ చైతన్యపూర్ణమైన నీ మనోహర రూపమును చూసినంతనే మానవులు కామమోహాది వికారములు నశించి పునర్జన్మ లేని మహోన్నత పరమపదమును పొందుతున్నారు. లోకులను ఇలా ముక్తులను గావించు ఉద్దేశముతోనే నువ్వు ఈ ఇలలో అవతరించావు. సీయింగ్ థై జెంటిల్ ఫామ్ విచ్ ఇస్ కన్స్టిట్యూటెడ్ ఆఫ్ ప్యూర్ సత్వ అండ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఫ్రీ from the contamination of passions and attachments. man attains to that status from which there is no return. Thou hast, for this purpose, manifested thyself as Ramakrishna on this earth. Om Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amrutangamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Tat Sat. Sarvavyapi Sarvottamadu Sarvagnudaina Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna Pada Padmalaku శాష్టాంగ నమస్కారం చేస్తున్నామని భావించండి. మనస్సులోనే నమస్కారం చేసుకోండి. రామకృష్ణుని చూడండి, మీ హృదయంలోనే ఉన్నారాయన. చూస్తూ ఆయన పాద పద్మాలకు నమస్కారం చేస్తున్నారని బాగా ప్రేమతో ఇష్టముతో ప్రణామం చేయండి. అదేవిధంగా మహాసరస్వతి, మహాలక్ష్మి, మహాగౌరీ, రాజరాజేశ్వరి, సరస్వతి అయిన శ్రీమాత శారదాదేవి పాదపద్మాలకు మనమందరము సాష్టాంగ నమస్కారం చేస్తున్నాం. మూర్తమహేశ్వరుడు, వీరేశ్వరుడు, యుగాచార్యుడు అయిన స్వామి వివేకానంద పాదపద్మాలకు మనము సాష్టాంగ నమస్కారం చేస్తున్నాం. అదేవిధంగా ఈరోజు పవిత్రమైన, శుద్ధమైన, గంభీరమైన దినము, పరమపూజ్య స్వామి బ్రహ్మానందజీ మహారాజు గారి జన్మదినము, జన్మతిథి, రామకృష్ణ సంఘ మొట్టమొదటి అధ్యక్షులు, శ్రీరామకృష్ణుల మానసపుత్రులు పుట్టినరోజు. ఆయనకి కూడా మనమందరము కూర్చున్న స్థలము నుండే సాష్టాంగ నమస్కారం, భక్తితో, జ్ఞానముతో, శ్రద్ధతో, ప్రేమతో ప్రణామం చేస్తున్నామని భావించండి. ఓం శాంతి 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 హరిహి ఓం. Next 20-25 minutes, 30 minutes, I shall be speaking in English on the life and teachings of Swami Brahmanandaji, so that people from all over the country who are watching this will be benefited. Last 10-15 minutes, we'll switch on to our bhasha, our language, to understand or get connected with Swami Brahmanandaji and Bhagavad Gita. మధ్యలో భగవంతుడి అనుగ్రహంతో కొన్ని తెలుగు వాక్యాలు ఉపయోగిస్తాను, మీకు కష్టమవకూడదని. టుడే ఈజ్ ఎ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ డే. వన్ ఈజ్ హిస్టారికల్, ది సెకండ్ ఈజ్ స్పిరిచువల్. హిస్టరీ ఇన్ వివేకానంద's లైఫ్. 13th February 1893, his first lecture in his life given in Mehboob College in Secunderabad. 90% or 95% of the people of Hyderabad or Telangana or Andhra do not know this. Very sad. They only refer to Chicago speech, but they forgot Mehboob College speech in his life. So I request all of you to study Vivekananda's life in detail and what happened in Hyderabad for 1 week, not for one day. He came on 10th February, stayed till 17th February, went round the entire city, important pilgrims, important visiting places, met the Nawab, the brother-in-law of the Nizam, had lot of discussion on Hinduism, on image worship and religion. Then on the request of the local people, he spoke in Mehboob College for more than an hour. 1,000 people at that time came to listen to Swami Vivekananda, Mehboob College grounds. The hall is still there, rebuilt and remade. Today we had a small function, taking all the students and Swami elders. So it is a very important. And what was the topic? My mission to the West. Because at the time he decided that he will go to the West. So they said, why are you going to the West? What is the program? What is your idea? So he spoke in English for 1 hour and then 17th February went back to Chennai, Chennai to Rajasthan, Rajasthan to Mumbai and Mumbai to America, and the rest is history. But don't forget, don't neglect 13th February 1893. Then 13th February 1897, 4 years later, when he came back from America. అమెరికాని జయించి విశ్వానంతా జయించి విశ్వ మానవుడయ్యాడు వివేకానంద. భారతదేశ పరిక్రమం పర్యటనలో వీర సన్యాసి అని పేరు ఆయనకి. వీర సన్యాసి, హీరోయిక్ మాంక్. అమెరికాను జయించిన తర్వాత విశ్వమత మహాసభ అయిన తర్వాత హీ బికేమ్ విశ్వ విజేత. విశ్వ విజేత వివేకానంద. అండ్ లేటర్ ఆఫ్టర్ 4 years హీ సెడ్, I don't belong to India or America or Calcutta or Hyderabad. I belong to the whole universe. And people call him Vishwa Manava, Vishwa Guru, Vishwa Vandya. 13th February 1897 in Chennai, he gave a very important lecture in the evening. Very important. All of you should study at least 10 times. Because we forget, we overlook some important points. Malli malli chadavali, malli malli chadavali, malli malli chadavali. Vitamin tablet teeskunnattu malli chadavali. Swamiji margadarshanam vellipovali. Inga vere margam ledu. Aa sheershika emiti? Vedanta, its application to Indian life. That is the title of that lecture. Nearly 5,000 to 6,000 people listened to Vivekananda. Vedanta, its application to Indian life. Pratyekamaina oka tala toli palikadi sheershikadi. Very interesting. Why Indian life? Pratyekata undi. Na chaduvute telustundi. There's something very special which Vivekananda wanted from all of you, from all of us. Haindava matam mariyu Vedantam. Haindava jeevitam mariyu Vedantam. Application Vivekananda Kurer. He wanted us to apply, not just to appreciate. Pustaka jnanam unte labham ledu, tattva jnanam penchukovali. Adi Swamiji pratyekata. So please read that. Two important lectures. My Mission to the West, it is not available, full lecture. Summary is there in the book. And one book we have published, small book, Hyderabad, bilingual, Swami Vivekananda in Hyderabad. Small book, 10 rupees. It is available in the bookstall. Please purchase, not one or two. Give to an auto driver who can read. Give to a bus driver who can read. You are going by bus, you are going by auto, you are going by taxi, you are going to the market, you are going to some shop. You are going to a vegetable market tomorrow. Ask him, sir, tamudu, anna, can you read? This go. Chadu idi. He will never forget you. So many wonderful incidents are there. How a shopkeeper became a saint. How a butcher became a saint. By reading, by getting one teaching of Ramakrishna Vivekananda. So that is your dharma, that is your sadhana, that is your what you call kartavyam, duty, responsibility, your spiritual practice by doing jnanadanam. People give annadanam. Our Swami tells in the office, people will come give, they want to give annadana. For 5 years it is booked. Annadana. Why annadana? People will, we have it sufficient. Give for jnanadanam, knowledge. So in that way, 13th February, very important. In Ramakrishna Mata Vivekananda life history, please read. And today, a very important day, pavitramaina dinam, shuddhamaina dinam, gambhiramaina dinam, sadharanamaina suryastama suryodayamaina dinam kaadu. Tithi prakaram jarupukuntam kabatti. English calendar, it changes, it fixed. But saints, sages, divine personalities, we don't go by English calendar. We go by the Vishuddha Siddhanta Panchikam. So today, Swami Brahmanandaji, Manasaputra. Manasaputra. Sri Ramakrishna wanted somebody with his vibrations. He could talk to somebody. He's fed up with worldly matter. He said, oh mother, please send somebody with whom I can talk, who can understand me, who can be with me, who can be with me. Because others are coming, all are going, nobody with me. So he said, Sri Ramakrishna prayed, mother, I want someone to be my constant companion. Bring me a boy who is pure-hearted and intensely devoted to you. Pure-hearted and devotion. Shuddha manasu. Pavitravaina manas. Then after few days, Sri Ramakrishna saw one vision. Bhavatarini is telling, putting one child in his lap and said, he is your son. Sri Ramakrishna was shocked. Mother, will I also have a son? He understood in the physical way. Mother said, no, not in the physical sense. As you wanted, mind-bound son, Manasaputra. And after a few days, Sri Ramakrishna had another vision. What is that? As he was seeing the Ganga, standing on the bank of the Ganga, he saw 100-petaled lotus blooming on the bosom of the Ganga, each of its petals with exquisite loveliness. On the lotus, two divine boys were dancing with anklets on their feet. One of them was Sri Krishna himself, and the other, the same boy he had seen in the earlier vision. Along with Sri Krishna, another boy is also dancing, and that boy is the same boy which Mother Kali showed. Their dance was beautiful. Every movement they made seemed to splash bliss from an ocean of sweetness. Sri Ramakrishna was lost in ecstasy. Ananda Mahasagaram Mulipera Sri Ramakrishna. After a few days, this boy is coming. Rakhal Chandra Ghosh. What a wonder, what a wonder. See the Leeladhyana. This is called Leeladhyana. Sri Ramakrishna mentions 4 kinds of meditation you can do as per your mindset. Dhyanam number 1, Namadhyanam. Namadhyanam. Meditate on the name of God. Rama, 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 Rama. Become exhausted. Become tired in repeating the name of Rama or Krishna. Hanuman used to do it. Gopalerma used to do it. Shabari used to do it. Namadhyanam. Rama, Rama, Rama. Meera did it. Meerabai. Annamacharya did it. Bhadrachara Ramadas did it. Tukaram did it. Purandaradas. Namadhyana, Namadhyana, Nam. They did not give big lectures or big books. Patal. Antaramamayam. Nameruchi. Ityadi. Namadhyanam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Namadhyanam. Blood used to come from their skin, so much intense meditation on the name of God, Rama, Rama, Rama. Second is Rupa Dhyanam, meditate on the form of God. After Nama, Rupa. Nama, Rupa, Ek, they say, Nama, Rupa, Ek, Kaya, Chaya. When you want to call somebody by name, immediately in your mind, there is a form also. Understand? So Nama, Rupa will go together. Third, Nama Dhyana, Rupa Dhyana. Third is Leela Dhyana. This is what we are reading now. Leela Dhyana, story, incidents. You read the Bhagavatam, you meditate, close your eyes and meditate. We read, but afterwards we do other work also. We don't do Dhyana. Leela Dhyana. You read Ramayana, you read Mahabharata, you read Ramakrishna Kathamrita. Leela Dhyanam. The fourth is Guna Dhyanam. Meditate on the qualities of God. Daivi Sampath or Vibhuti Yoga. Rajavidya, Rajaguhya Yoga. What are they? Gunas, qualities. Vaibhavam. 13th chapter, Kshetra Kshetrakna Vibhagayo. Meditate on that. Bhakti Yogam, there are certain qualities of Bhakta, Guna, qualities. Four kinds of Dhyanam are available, can be done, no problem. No papam, no punyam, you can do it. Certified by Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna. First, Nama Dhyanam, as much as possible. Rupa Dhyanam, form of God, you forget. That's why there is a book, How to See God with Eyes Opened. Wonderful book. There, meditation on Ramakrishna's feet, Rupa. Swami Chaitananji writes, when you see Ramakrishna's feet is there. We see the picture. What do you see? You should connect it from Kamarpukur to Kalkata, Kalkata to Kamarpukur, and with this feet he went round Panchavati, with this feet he went round Dakshineshwar, with this feet he went to Kalkata, with this feet he was dancing. This becomes meditation. His hands, Ramakrishna's hands. Ramakrishna's smile. Observe Ramakrishna's smile. Ramakrishna's smile is Sita Mata's smile. How many of you know it? Sita Mata entered into Ramakrishna in Dakshineshwar, Panchavati. And the blessing mother gave was her smile. Mugdhulaipayavaru prajalu. Ramakrishna Lachiru Navu. Sitamma Talli Navvadi. Yanta Prema, Yanta Pavitra Vaina Chiru Navu Sri Ramakrishna. Dhani Mi Dhyanam Jayadi. Oka video jodandi, video. Inkeda video lenduku manaki. Ive unnapudu. So Ramakrishna's Leela Dhyanam is shown. He saw and Pratyaksham Aipadu. Rakhal Chandra Ghosh. Sri Ramakrishna looked at Rakhal for a few moments. After this, master talked to Rakhal. In the presence of Sri Ramakrishna, Rakhal, ante childhood friend of Sri Krishna. Childhood friend of Sri Krishna, Rakhal. Gopa Gopil samayamlo Rakhal undevadu. Pramukhudu. Shri Krishna's friend, Atputam. Shri Krishna dances, they Leela Jusad, Shri Ramakrishna. So once he got attracted to Shri Ramakrishna, nothing could stop him. Always Ramakrishna, Ramakrishna. He was running to Dakshineshwar. Small boy, young boy, 12 years, 13 years, full of ananda, full of joy. Recalling his early days, Sri Ramakrishna said, no words can describe Rakhal's living in a state of ecstasy. He was like a little child, helpless in its mother's arms, surrendering itself completely to her, always conscious of the divine relationship. And when he was near me, I also was transported into a higher spiritual consciousness. I used to play with him, just as Yashoda Mata played with her divine child Krishna. What a wonderful relationship between the master and the disciple. This is recorded history. not simply kalpanika or some wuha. It's not fiction. So Sri Ramakrishna also became a mother and Rakhal became his child. They used to play. Sri Ramakrishna used to feed him. And one day Sri Rakhal was very, very hungry. And he told Ramakrishna, very hungry, feeling very hungry, I want to eat something. Ramakrishna will not keep quiet. Mother, you see. He went to the bank of the Ganga and cried, "Oh Gaurdasi, my Rakhal is hungry. Please bring some food." Advertisement chestunnaru Sri Ramakrishna. Rakhal ki vipreetha kopam vachesindi. Naaku aakali aithe prapancham anta meer advertisement chestunnaru. Anta cheyale meer advertisement. Then Sri Ramakrishna, what is wrong in that? You are hungry? I told everybody, otherwise where I will go to market and bring food for you. See, Gaurdasi brought wonderful items. Eat first, don't talk. Sri Ramakrishna used to take care of every disciple. Whether it was Swami Vivekananda, whether it was Adbhutananda, whether it was Niranjananda, whether it was Brahmananda, Faradim, he was their mother. Tameva mata, tvameva pita. He was taking care. What we read in Puranas, people saw in Dakshineshwar temple compound. Then at the feet of Sri Ramakrishna, so many stories, so many incidents, so many wonderful things, we cannot go into every detail. It's just a parichayam, just a satsangam for a few minutes. You should take up some responsibility and do some self-study. New people or old people. Old means not in age, those who have been coming here. A few days, one day, Rakhal is meditating in Dakshineshwar. One is the main temple, those who have seen the picture of Dakshineshwar temple, Mother Kali temple, Bhavatarini. And opposite there is a big hall, music hall, Nahabat. So Rakhal is meditating. Sri Ramakrishna approached him in ecstasy and touched him, gave him a mantra. Look, there is your Ishta. Just sparsha matrena. Indaka chadivam. Samsparsha matrena nrunam samadhim. Samsparsha matrena nrunam samadhim. Vidhaya sadyo bhavi Ramakrishna. Mere touch, you gave them experience. That is what Abhedanji writes. He touched him, high spirit. There is your Ishta. Chupinchesaru Sri Ramakrishna. Anandam, anandam for 3 days and 3 nights, Rakhal did not come down from that high spiritual consciousness. In the Gospel of Ramakrishna, Master Mahashaya or Yam, he writes, Rakhal has grown into a very sweet character. He practices japa unceasingly. Always lips were moving. The Ishta Mantra which Sri Ramakrishna gave continuously, unceasing prayer, unceasing japa. It is called ajapa japa. You should observe whether you are doing it by force or whether it is coming naturally from your heart. Ajapa japa, spontaneously it should come. The Rakhal Maharajas or Raja Maharaj or Maharaj or some Brahmananda, ajapa japa, it's a flow. Ganga is flowing and milk and honey is flowing and bhava samadhi, always in that bhava. I look at him and notice his mental condition. I often feel inspired and lose myself in ecstasy. During this period, 15 years, 16 years, 17 years boy, Rakhal had many visions. Everywhere he could see God. He could see the spiritual consciousness. And he could see what is inside you. What is inside you, like somebody seeing through a cupboard. I am seeing water through this glass. Rakhal used to see the nature of the devotee, nature of the people through their panchakosha. And sometimes he used to avoid, sometimes he used to talk to them. That was the changes, that was the development that he was getting, he was experiencing. During this period, another interesting thing happened. Keshav Chandra Sen, Brahma Samaj Nayakudu, disciple of Raja Ram Mohan Roy, powerful speaker, powerful leader in Calcutta. His speeches were so powerful, and Queen Victoria was listening. That was his command over the language and subject, philosophy, etc. All these young people were going, running to town hall in Calcutta to listen to Keshav Chandra Sen's speeches of philosophy of Brahma Samaj. Rakhal was there. Narendra was there, future Vivekananda. In Brahma Samaj philosophy, there is no Akara Puja. There is no worship of God with form. Only Nirakara Puja. But Sri Ramakrishna made such a wonderful companion, wonderful group of these wonderful people. Vivekananda is doing this Nirakara Puja, Nirakara Sadhana. But one day he came, Sri Ramakrishna made him bow down to Mother Kali in the Dakshineshwar temple. Narendra saw, he became very angry. Hey, what is this? You are going to Mother temple to do puja and offer, doing namaskaram to Vigraham? Have you not taken the oath there? From that time, Rakal Maharaj avoided Vivekananda. He never used to, he is coming this side, he will run away. This fellow is scolding. He is confusing me. But Ramakrishna called Vivekananda and said, his mental attitude is not Nirakara. His mental attitude is Bhakti, Sakara. Don't disturb him like this. Allow him to come and go. But the friendship, you see, till the end how it matured between Narendra and Rakhal, Swami Vivekananda and Swami Brahmananda. How each one respected, loved each other as much more than their blood brother and their family member. And in Kashipur, every day he would talk to Naren for hours together. In the course of one conversation, he told him, Rakhal has been keen intelligence, has keen intelligence of a king. Who is telling this? Swami Vivekananda, Narendra found out Rakhal has the intelligence of a king. He can rule a kingdom. If he chooses, he could rule a kingdom. Taking the hint and understanding that the master wanted Rakhal to be their leader, Naren lost no time in bringing this about. One day, when all the young disciples were seated together, Naren spoke of Rakhal's greatness and announced, "From today, we shall call Rakhal our king." From today, we shall call Rakhal our king. The others gladly agreed. Thus, from that day, they called him Raja, the king, or just Maharaj. So, whenever we address among the direct disciples, Raja Maharaj, we say, or only Maharaj will call. Became Swami Brahmananda, the first Adhyaksha, first president of the Ramakrishna order for nearly 21 years. 1900, Vivekananda withdrew. He said, my time has come, now Raja will take over. He is the king, he is our leader. So whatever accounts, administrative matters, everything he put in the hands of Raja Maharaj. And officially, Raja Maharaj is the president. Vivekananda is just the ex officio president. And for 21 years, 1921, he passed away. Till that time, he took the Ramakrishna mission forward. Fortunate he came, Swami Ramakrishnaji brought him to South India, stayed for many years in Chennai, Bangalore, went to small villages in Kerala and spread the message. Wherever he went, that spiritual power, the spiritual consciousness is flowing. In railway station somebody saw, who is he? From which prantham of this country is coming? Look at his walk, look at his face, he is a Raja. And some people confused, seeing him and seeing Sri Ramakrishna. From backside, both are same. Their walk, their look, their body language. Ramakrishna was Brahmananda. Brahmananda was Ramakrishna. Because Manasaputra. As a young monk, Raja Maharaj was blessed with sannyasa. And Vivekananda called him, Raja, from today you will be Swami Brahmananda. Just like all the other disciples, Raja Maharaj also, Brahmanandaji also wanted to go away to tapasya, absorb himself in solitude, absorb in God. Hours and hours of meditation, hours and hours of spiritual sadhana in Vrindavan, in Kankal, in the Himalayas. Somebody asked Swami Subodhanandaji asked, brother, already Ramakrishna blessed you with high experience. Why are you doing sadhana so much? Why are you sitting for meditation? Yes, Ramakrishna gave us the taste, gave us the ruchi, gave us the experience once. Now I am making it my own. They continue to do tapas. Sometimes no food, sometimes heavy food. They maintained that balance, maintained that high, deep spiritual consciousness. In Vrindavan, Swami Turiyanandaji and Brahmanandaji tested, let us not go for bhiksha. Let us see whether Mother Radha will give us food. We are her children. They stopped going. The whole night meditating on that high spiritual consciousness. Morning they found one bhakta coming and said, I saw whole day you are not eating. Please take Radha's prasadam. The total surrender of their tana mana dhana. Mother Radha blessed them. Like that, so many incidents are there on the bank of the Godavari, on the bank of the Yamuna, on the bank of the Ganga. Wherever he went, Raja Maharaj was doing his meditation, doing his sadhana. Swamiji, look at the comparison. Swamiji with his dynamic, aggressive personality. Simhagarjana. He could wake up a man from the sleep of ignorance. Maharaj, that is Swami Brahmananda, with his characteristic serenity, could show him the way to mold his life in God. Each paid memorable tribute to the other. Through Swamiji, said Brahmananda, the world has come to know of Sri Ramakrishna, but for him, very few could have understood our master's genius. And in the words of Swamiji, Raja is the greatest treasure house of spirituality. Swami Sharadanandaji replied, if Vivekananda was loved and cherished by the master as the means by which his spiritual mission was to be proclaimed to the world, Swami Brahmananda was no less valued by him as the future head of his organization. He used to tell his disciples, other monks of the Ramakrishna order, how they inspired, how they made everybody a great spiritual treasure house. I am reading a teaching of Swami Brahmananda, his own words. The one purpose of life is to know God. What Sri Ramakrishna said, Jivita Lakshyam Ishvara Darshanam. What we are doing, what we are working for. The one purpose of life is to know God. Plunge deep into the sea of bliss and become immortal. Attain knowledge and devotion. Then serve God in mankind. Work is not the end of life. Disinterested work is a means of attaining devotion. Meditate and dive deep within. Know that God alone is real. Keep at least 3/4 of your mind in God. 3/4 of your mind in God. It is enough if you give 1/4 to service or to the world. In another place, Swami Brahmanji said, every devotee has got 21 people's capacity, possibility, samarthyam antam. 21 మంది పనిచేసే సామర్థ్యం మన అంతరంగంలో ఉంది, ఆంతరిక మనస్సులో ఉంది. అయితే మనం అలసిపోతాం, టైర్డ్ అయిపోతాం కొంచెం పని చేస్తే. ఎందుకు? ఆధ్యాత్మికతని మనం పెంచుకోలేదు, లోపల ఉండిపోయింది అది. దాహం 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 అని గంగానది ఒడ్డులో చూసుకొని మనం దాహం అని చచ్చిపోతున్నాం. బ్రహ్మానంద బోధనలో ఆయన అంటారు, విప్ ద మైండ్ అంటారు, విప్ ద మైండ్. కొడారి తీసుకొని కొట్టు మనస్సుని. After all, it is your mind. Whip the mind. Anta stronga undali koni sarlu. Army bhasha cheptevaru. No laziness, no tiredness. You have to get up and meditate. Yes, you must work. But I insist you devote yourself more to spiritual practice and meditation. In contemplation of God, Maharaj was more interested in the spiritual growth of his disciples. Maharaj kept a watchful eye on the progress of each member of the Ramakrishna order. He turned our hearts continually towards God and directed our actions and the activities of the mission towards the unfoldment of inner strength, which alone can benefit mankind physically, morally, and spiritually. Sharirika vikas, manasika vikas, adhyatmika vikas anundi modu. Psychology lo. Spiritual psychology. Sharirika vikas, we know, we are seeing your body weight, your age, your height, your degree. Everything we know, physically. Sharirika vikas. Good food, exercise, you know, sharirika vikas. Manasika vikas, aksharabhyasam, science, technology, some account, some job, something, manasika vikas, concentration, ichcha shakti, discrimination, devotion is a manas. But what about the adhyatmika vikas? Parents look at sharirika vikas and manovikas, not the adhyatmika vikas. That's why the fellow will be misbehave later. He will insult his own mother and father. Adhyatmika vikas we are not seeing. We are not thinking about it. Anybody coming to Ramakrishna Mat? No, don't go. What is this? He can go to opposite place. Or he can run behind somebody. Then parents are happy. I have seen. I have seen mother, father coming and tying up their son and taking and putting him in marriage hall. Karma. This fellow after 5 days came back. No adhyatmika vikas. They don't want. If the society has to evolve, it is at the spiritual level. It is at the spiritual level. So that is how Swami Brahmanji insisted, even to the monks of the Ramakrishna order. Swamiji's work, yes, but you should have meditation also. Or give more time to meditation. And when you meditate more, when you do the sadhana more, when you pray more, your capacity increases. And you can do more work in less time. That is yoga. Yoga karma su kaushalam. Sri Krishna said in 2nd chapter. Yoga karma su kaushalam. Yoga is efficiency in action. So to conclude, if last, how Maharaj left his body. Very, very interesting, very inspiring. Few days before, Swami Nirvanandaji, who became the vice president later, who was the disciple of Swami Brahmananda, he said, he was serving Maharaj, saw him sitting on his bed in a very grave mood. Sri Ramakrishna, I woke suddenly and saw Sri Ramakrishna standing just there. He did not speak to me. He stood there silently for a while and then disappeared. I don't understand it. I cannot give my mind to the things of this world any longer. The mind wants to take complete refuge in him and him alone. Before the birthday of Sri Ramakrishna, 2 days later, he had a slight attack of cholera. A devotee asked, Maharaj, are you suffering very much? Please try to realize, Maharaj answered, that in my condition, I have to bear all physical suffering, patiently and without complaint. He called in all the disciples and devotees who were present by his side. For each he had a blessing and an affectionate word. Ah, my children, never forget God. And you will realize the highest good. Do not grieve. I shall be with you always. Once more he became absorbed in his transcendental vision. And he said with a sweet, tender voice, I am floating. Mahayogul anubhavam chudandi. I am floating. I am floating on the leaf of faith and knowledge in the ocean of Brahman. Suddenly he exclaimed, Ah, the feet of Sri Ramakrishna. I know them. Viveka, my brother. Vivekananda, Premananda, Yogananda. All of them he saw. With his divine insight, he recognized the brother disciples who had already passed away. Ayanakanta mundu velu mahasamadhi pondaru. Vallandarini chusaru. He began to describe his visions. The blissful ocean of Brahman. Om. Salutations to the Supreme Brahman. Om. Salutations to the Supreme Atman. Om. The mind doesn't want to come down from Brahman. Pour Brahman into Brahman, said Maharaj slowly. Brother, Sri Ramakrishna is real. His divine incarnation is real. Suddenly, out of the silence, the voice of Maharaj was heard. Ah, that inexpressible light! Ramakrishna, the Krishna of my Ramakrishna. I am the shepherd boy. Put anklets on my feet. I want to dance with my Krishna. I want to hold his hand. The little boy Krishna. Ah, Krishna, my Krishna, you have come. Krishna, Krishna. Can't you see him? Haven't where I want pilchi cheptunnaratra. Can't you see him? Don't you have eyes to see? How beautiful my Krishna. On the lotus, eternal, the sweet one. My play is over now. Look, look, the child Krishna is caressing me. He is calling me to come away with him. I am coming, I am coming. The whole atmosphere of the hall where he was lying seemed to vibrate with this emotion. During the early hours of the morning, he remained silent for some time. At 7 o'clock, he awoke and was again possessed by this high spiritual mood. As that last evening faded into night, April 10, 1922, his half eyes closed, opened, and he gazed into the distance, his eyes shining with brilliance and unspeakable beauty. He said before leaving the body, Ashirvachanam, Sri Krishna told in 10th chapter, we are reading, Name Bhakta Pranashyati, Name Bhakta Pranashyati. Maharaj is told because he is Krishna's companion, Krishna Bandhu. Em chepparu aina? Do not grieve. Do not grieve. I shall be with you always. See the words? After his passing away, we all had the feeling Maharaj was intensely present with us. He was closer to us than ever before. More than 40 years have passed since that day. This is written by Maharaj's disciple, Swami Prabhavananda, when he was asked to go to America. Swami Shivananda told Swami Prabhavananda, Never forget that you have seen the Son of God, you have seen God. Not just the Son of God, you have seen God. That is Brahmanandaji's status. For the benefit of new people and old people also, 7 books are there. 5 books in Telugu, 5 books in English, 2 books in Telugu for the benefit of study, sadhana. God lived with them, number 1. The eternal companion, Swami Brahmananda and his teachings, which is translated into Telugu as Brahmananda Bodhanalu. Reminiscences of Swami Brahmananda, andaru kachitanga chadavali idi. Angla bhashalo Telugu lo anuvadam avaledu. And shishyulu దగ్గరగా ఉండి ఆయన ప్రత్యక్షంగా ఉండి దక్షిణ భారతంలో ఉత్తర భారతంలో కలకత్తాలో ఇంకా వేరే బెనారస్లో ఎలాగ ఆయన వ్యక్తిత్వాన్ని చూశారు ఆయన సాధన చేశారు ఆయన దగ్గర నేర్చుకున్నారనే రెమినిజెన్సెస్ చాలా అద్భుతం ది మైండ్ బాండ్ సన్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీరామకృష్ణ అని ఉంది రెమినిజెన్సెస్ ఆఫ్ స్వామి బ్రహ్మానంద అనే బుక్ స్టాల్లో ఉన్నాయి మద్రాస్ మట్ నుంచి అద్భుతమైన ఇంకో పెద్ద పుస్తకం పబ్లిష్ అయింది రీసెంట్గా స్వామి బ్రహ్మానంద యాజ్ వీ సా హిమ్ దీంట్లోనూ వివరాలు ఎక్కువ అనువాదం బెంగాలీ భాష నుంచి వేరే భాషల నుంచి అనువాదం చేసి అది ఇంగ్లీష్లో ప్రచురణ చేశారు గ్రేట్ సేయింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ స్వామి బ్రహ్మానంద అని పాకెట్ బుక్ ఆయన జపం గురించి ధ్యానం గురించి ఈ పుస్తకంలోనే ఉంది ఎవరెవరు ఆఫీస్కి వెళ్ళి చదవాలనుకుంటారో ఆ పుస్తకం బ్యాగ్లో పెట్టుకొని వెళ్ళచ్చు గ్రేట్ సేయింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ స్వామి బ్రహ్మానంద తెలుగులో బ్రహ్మానంద బోధనలు దైవంతో సహజీవనం ఈ రెండు పుస్తకాల్లో వివరాలు ఉన్నాయి, ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ ఉన్నాయి, అందరూ చదివి బ్రహ్మానంద స్వామిని ప్రార్థన చేసి ఆ భావం, ఆ భక్తి, ఆ శ్రద్ధ, ఆ ఒక ప్రేమ విశ్వాసం మనలో ఇంకా పెరగాలి పెరగాలి పెరగాలని కోరుకుంటూ నేటి బ్రహ్మాన స్వామికి మన ప్రణామాలు అర్పించుకుందాం. ఆరతి భజన ఉంది, అటెండ్ అయ్యి ప్రసాదం తీసుకొని వెళ్ళండి. మళ్ళీ వచ్చే శనివారం మన యథా కార్యక్రమం ముందుకి తీసుకువెళదాం. ॐ शांति 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 हरिः ॐ तत्सत् श्रीरामकृष्णार्पणमस्तु. लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु. जय श्रीमत्स्वामी ब्रह्मानंद जी महाराज जी की जय. जय राम कृष्ण.
Yeah. Yeah. तस्मात् त्वमेव शरणं मम दीन बन्धो कृत्यं करोति कलुषं कुहकान्त काली श्नान्तं शिवं सुविमलं तव नाम नाथ यस्मादहं त्वशरणो जगदे कृष्णाय नमो नमः।
नमोस्तुते
जय नारायणी नमोस्तु ते जय नारायणी नमोस्तु ते जय नारायणी नमोस्तु ते।
प्रकृतिं परमां अभयां वरदा नररूपधरां जनतापहरा शरणागत सेवक तोषकरी प्रणमामि परां जननी सदा चरणाम्बुरहामृत शांति सुधा पिवा भृंग मनो भव रोगहरा प्रणमामि परा जननी जगता।
कृपां कुरु महादेवी सुतेषु प्रणतेषु च चरणाश्रयदानेन कृपामयि नमोऽस्तु ते। लज्जापटावृते नित्यं शारदे ज्ञानदायिके पापे कृपामयि नमोऽस्तु ते। रामकृष्णगतप्राणां तन्नाम श्रवणप्रिया तद्भावरञ्जिताकारा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः। पवित्रं चरितं यस्याः पवित्रं जीवनं तथा पवित्रता स्वरूपिण्यै तस्यै गुरुमो नमो नमः। देवीं प्रसन्नां प्रणतातिहन्त्रीं योगेन्द्रपूज्यां युगधर्मपात्रीं तां शारदां भक्तिविज्ञानदात्रीं दयास्वरूपां प्रणमामि नित्यं। स्नेहेन बध्नासि मानोऽस्मदीयं दोषान् शेषान् सगुणीकरोषि। आहेतुना नो दयसे सदोषान् स्वाङ्के गृहीत्वा यदिदं विचित्रं प्रसीदमातर। जननीं शारदा देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयोः श्रुत्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः
भजनमाला पेज 200 200
जय जय राम कृष्ण भुवन मंगल जय 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 माता श्याम सुतती निरमल जय जय राम कृष्ण भुवन मंगल जय जय
राम कृष्ण भुवन मंगल
जय विवेकानंद परम दयाल
जय विवेक
सुत जय श्री राखाल
प्रभु रमानस सुत जय श्री राखाल
जय जय राम कृष्ण भुवन मंगल
जय
प्रेमानंद प्रेममाया कलेवारा
जय प्रेमानंद प्रेममाया कलेवारा
जय शिवानंद जय लीला सहचरा योगी योगानंद जय नित्यानिरंजन
योगी योगानंद जय नित्यानिरंजन
जय शशि गुरुपद दे गतनो मान
जय शशि
आनंद जय गत मोह बंध
अभेद आनंद जय गत मोह बंध
योग रत त्याग व्रत तुरिया आख्यात
योग रत त्याग
सेवा पारायण
प्रवीण गोपाल मात्र सेवा पारायण
शारद शारद पदे गत प्राण मान
चरित्र जय सुबोध सारण
नागवर त्याग वीर विवेक संबल
नागवर त्याग वीर विवेक संबल
कथा मृता
आकर
जय जय राम
रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं शरणं जय जय
रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण
शरणं शरणं जय जय रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं शरणं जय जय
रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं शरणं
कृपाहि केवलं कृपाहि केवलं शरणं प्रभो
कृपाहि केवलं कृपाहि केवलं कृपाहि केवलं शरणं
प्रभो कृपाहि केवलं कृपाहि केवलं कृपाहि केवलं शरणं प्रभो
कृपाहि केवलं कृपाहि केवलं
कृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं शरणं जय जय
रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं रामकृष्ण शरणं शरणं
शरणागतोऽहं
शरणागतोऽहं शरणागतोऽहं शरणम्
शरणागतोऽहं 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 शरणम्
प्रभु शरणागतोऽहं 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 शरणम्
शरणागतोऽहं 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 शरणम्
जय जय रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् शरणम्
जय जय राम
श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो नमः
नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो नमः
नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो नमः
नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो श्री गुरवे नमो नमः
जय जय रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् शरणम्
जय जय राम
कृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् शरणम्
जय जय रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् रामकृष्ण शरणम् शरणम्
रामकृष्ण रामकृष्ण जय जय रामकृष्ण
रामकृष्ण
राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण जय
जय राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
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 जय जय राम कृष्ण
जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय राम कृष्ण
राम कृष्ण राम कृष्ण जय जय
राम कृष्ण शरणम् राम कृष्ण शरणम् राम कृष्ण शरणम् शरणम्
जय जय राम कृष्ण शरणम्
कृष्ण शरणं
जय जय राम कृष्ण शरणं 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 शरणं
जय भगवान श्री राम कृष्ण देव की
जय
जय श्री शारदा माई की
जय
स्वामी विवेकानंद महाराज जी की
जय
स्वामी ब्रह्मानंद महाराज जी की
जय